some of the injured who were brought there yesterday, nobody deliberately targeted them. I don't think that people went out and selected those 27 people and decided to break legs, to shoot legs, and so on. Some of them were hit by stray bullets. And Maza, those of you in the MPP who think that you have to demonstrate party loyalty, no matter how stupid it is, you should wake up. Wake up to the realization that stray bullets do not discriminate against one party or the other. Stray bullets don't pick their targets. Stray bullets can hit anybody. So continue. Continue justifying Ayawaso's arrest program. Continue claiming that it is irrelevant at all. We will all suffer the consequences one after the other. You know, I mean, sometimes I hear some comments which worry me. I mean, this morning, a friend of mine sent me some comment that people were making on social media and so on. I feel like crying. I mean, they said, this is not the first time there has been violence in our elections, so we should ignore this one. This is like 81 and so on. What happened at Ayawaso West Wobon has never happened in our history. Never. Nowhere. Not even during the Martini Hu CPP battles. What happened has never happened in our history. And what is it that happened? That state security, state security, would actually organize vigilante groups, arm them, put face masks on their faces and so on, drive them in official police vehicles to participate, to go into an election area and shoot people. It has never happened in our history. This is the worst incidence of political violence in our history. Check the record. This is not like a Tiwa. This is not like anything which has happened before. This has never happened before. This is an escalation. This is abominable. This is the height. So, those of you who are making that argument, like, oh, it happened in Tiwa, it happened here, it happened there. This one has never happened anywhere before. And you know my worry. As we sat down yesterday at Balewashi or wherever, and as we saw the victims in pain and so on, we could not help but remind ourselves that those responsible for breaking legs, for shooting people, for attempted murder and so on, are still working in the security services being paid for by the Ghanaian taxpayer. Are you happy with that? That criminal element, that hoodlums, hooligans and gangsters are still being paid for by the taxpayers' money. I am scandalized. It's the biggest scandal. 1 year after they did the things that they did, they are still on the public payroll. Nobody has thought about removing them from office. Incredible development in our country. Now, Masa, if you go into Ayawaso West, you get many aspects of that development which are the first. I mean, they are historic. They've never happened before. A government, sets up a commission of inquiry. The government carefully selects the members of the Commission of Inquiry. They are no ordinary citizens. One of them, the chairperson, is the former head of the Commission for Human Rights and Administrative Justice. The other one is a distinguished lecturer of law at the University of Ghana. The other one is a police officer, in fact, the highest officer in the police service, Inspector General of Police, under President John Adekunle Akufo-Addo. my microphone trouble. Yeah, it's okay. It's the Inspector General of Police, appointed by no other person than President John Adekunle Akufo-Addo. Government appointed these people. Nobody dictated to government. And then, when they have written their report, the same government which selected them and so on says that the commission of inquiry is biased against it. Have you heard this before? It's the first in history. The commission that they themselves appointed, they say it's biased against them. The commission that they themselves appointed now is biased in favor of the opposition and against them. What kind of Kwikwanansi story is that? So look, if you look at this whole thing, every aspect of it, it's exceedingly boring.